So guys, week 3 of my quest for the British Isles, and as the thumbnail says at the top, it's getting hard. This week's been a tough week. I've once again hit another like 60 plus mile week, but it's starting to take its toll. I'm starting to get like pretty tired all the time, and it's starting to really kind of like get a lot harder in comparison. I'm waiting for that kind of second wind to happen about week probably 6 or 7, so probably it'll start to happen in like mid-November. I'll start to get like that little kick again, but for now it's starting to get really kind of hard and getting like to the graft of it now. I mean, like, you put it in perspective, I've run 4 weeks now plus 60 miles, so effectively I've ran from, if you have a look here, I've run from Liverpool to Carlisle and then back to Liverpool again, so basically ran home and back in the last 4 weeks, which, put it in that perspective, it sounds blooming stupid, but I'm going quite well at the moment, and sessions are starting to mount up together, which is really good. I'm starting to feel really, really strong, which is the positive. I just wish I didn't feel so tired all the time. Another point, sorry for the lack of footage in sessions this week. I need to find somebody to try and video sessions, because the problem is, obviously, like, my whole group run the session, as I explained before, so to find somebody to video is incredibly hard. But I'm gonna have a word with a couple of people and maybe have a look at getting like a GoPro and get a strap harness and see what we can work out from there, see if we can get some footage. Anyway, enjoy what I've got, and as I say, like, just keep subscribed to the channel because the support's been great so far. Just done an easy run this morning, quite like relaxed and controlled, and just before the track session tonight, and I can't help feeling that I'm getting into these like steady runs. I'm starting to feeling like quite good doing them as well, like, as in, like, they're starting to like flush my legs out before the track session later on, because I used to arrive to the track sessions and feel like it would take me a couple of reps to get into it. Whereas I feel now, because I do this run in the morning, I feel that, like, when I come to do the track session at night, I feel like my legs are kind of already ready to kind of go again. So, yeah, it's working out really well, these morning runs at the moment. So I'm starting to feel, like, really, really good. Like, they were crap when I first started, like, in the first couple of weeks. Whereas now, I'm getting quite into them and just need to just keep plodding on now on another week of hard graft.
Come on, last lap, guys.
Come on, last lap.
6:57. For those who can hear me, I say, do not despair. The misery that is now upon us is but the passing of greed, the bitterness of men who fear the way of human progress. The hate of men will pass, and dictators die. And the power they took from the people will return to the people. And so long as men die, liberty will never perish. Don't give yourselves to these unnatural men, with machine minds and machine hearts. You are not machines, you are not cattle, you are men. You, the people, have the power to make this life free and beautiful, to make this life a wonderful adventure. Let us use that power, let us all unite.
It will rise!
So, this morning, we are at Shirdley Park for Kenyon Hills. Saturday morning, and this session is never fun at all, and plus the weather outside is absolutely throwing it down. So I have the big beats on for the pre-sesh. Hopefully these can fucking get me through today. So Hills session done, stroke Kenyon Hills, which would like basically hard reps for 5 minutes worth of effort. I am absolutely buggered. Also, sorry I couldn't get anybody to video yet again. That seems to be the one thing that I'm struggling with in these diaries, because obviously my group do the session as well, and Adrian's on the watch all the time. It's quite hard to combine the video in and getting it, but once I do and find somebody who can actually video properly, we'll start getting some proper sessions in. But until then, I can tell you what I'm doing, which is quite good, and I'm getting as much video in as I can. Okie dokie, guys, welcome to my first shoe review on my actual quest for the British Open. Now, like I was saying before in my very first video, I don't get any kind of funding whatsoever, so I don't get any kind of shoe deals, I don't have any contracts with anybody, so I'm going to be giving like my view from somebody who has to go out and like buy their shoes all the time, and like obviously I know the pain of going out and buying shoes, so I'll literally give you the honest review from somebody who does a lot of miles and goes through roughly a pair of shoes probably once every 2 months or so, give or take, depending on mileage throughout the year. So I've been doing the majority of my mileage now for winter so far in these. Okay, these are the Nike Odyssey. So far I'd recommend, well, I'd probably say no to them so far, mostly because one of my mates used to work for Start Fitness, who has just moved up here. He said I'm a very like neutral like foot planter, and this is a dynamic one. So for me, it's been good, but I've been struggling with the fact that it's quite a thin fitting shoe at the very front here. Now for me, that's not very good, because obviously like I'm planting on my toes the entire time, and I tend to plant my foot like that and then roll in. Now what tends to happen is that if I have a shoe that's too tight, my toes tend to clench really close together, and then they tend to rub, and then I end up getting really, really bad blisters. So for me, the Nike Odyssey, I really didn't enjoy it, so that will not be bought again. So I have upgraded now to the Pegasus 33. Now I did have the Pegasus 30 and they were the best shoe I've ever had. Now I couldn't get the Pegasus 30 again, but these are very similar to the Pegasus 30 apparently, and they've got the same width across the forefoot here, so hopefully I won't have any of those blister issues whatsoever. Now for being like an incredibly toey runner, they've got a big heel bit here which is absolutely perfect, so obviously when I land on my toe and then spring up again, I'm not going to have any like default, I'm not going to have too much here, which is quite good. But apart from that, I'm going to see how it goes. I went in for a run in them tonight for the first time and they felt really great as soon as I put them on. So I'd recommend to anybody who's a toey athlete like myself I'd recommend that you go and get a pair of Pegasus 33s because so far I'm absolutely loving them. But I'll do a recap in a couple of weeks, let you know if I've had any blisters or any issues with them. So, if you enjoy this video, just give it a like and just basically keep supporting the channel. That'd be absolutely awesome. Cheers.